As a child, I was very fascinated with the idea of a personal journal, a space where I can pour out my feelings, my experiences, and my dreams. I used to write in a journal even as a teenager. As I grew up and then began college and then work, the thought of jotting down my already hectic and stressful day was quite exhausting. At that time, writing was the only purpose of journaling for me. A whole new world of ideas and thoughts opened up for me when I discovered creative journaling. I began to understand that journal was more than a notebook. I realized that the journal was a great tool for self-discovery and a wonderful medium to explore oneself in all aspects of life. Journaling allows you to write about your feelings and thoughts, wonder about the whys and hows. It gives you a platform to give life to your dreams and aspirations. Putting them in ink makes them much more real, much more achievable. With journaling, one can acknowledge their fears and weaknesses and slowly turn them into strengths. You can document everyday events and moments from your life, turning them into cherished memories. Overall, a journal, all in all, is a reflection of you as a person on paper in your own words. Over time, when you read one of your old journals, you will understand the true power of words. How words, which were written in haste one day, maybe because you were too happy and excited, or maybe too upset to slow down, that will help you understand why you did what you did or how important that moment was in your life. Journaling helps one evolve as a person. It also is an amazing medium to pass on a little bit of yourself to your future generations. Your journals will give them a deeper insight into the kind of a person you are at this point in your life. In the past year, I have moved from a memory keeper to an avid journaler. I used to just document some particular events, some memories in my journal earlier. Now I explore my belief system and my thought process. Keeping a journal is a great way to build better habits as well. I developed the habit of gratitude through my gratitude jar and my gratitude journal. People keep habit trackers, food trackers, mood trackers, to name a few, in order to identify patterns in their life. Once you know that you need a journal, the next step is to choose a style that you're comfortable with. There are tons of options available outside. I'm just sharing a couple of basic few with you. The first option is notebooks. These are simple and easy for writing. The next option that I came up with was bullet journals. These are best for planning. Some online apps are also available as an option if you want to maintain soft copies of your journals. Another option is art journaling if you like to express your thoughts through art. Personally, I use a junk journal myself as I am an extremely visual and tactile person. I love mixing colors, patterns, and textures for my layouts. Whichever style works for you, choose it and begin. So I hope this inspires you to start your journal. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave them in a comment below. I am thinking to do more videos on creative journaling like these. Let me know in the comments below if you're interested in watching. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. I hope you have a happy day ahead. Bye.